Thank you. Thank you. of destruction, baptisms of fire. Most of this Hibernia squad are too young to remember dire straits in any form. They'll need to be brothers in arms tonight as the Czechs come bouncing into Tala. Hello, good evening and welcome to the National Basketball Arena for the final group game in the FIBA Europe Cup. For Hibernia, the weeks have flown by, albeit without a win. For this evening's visitors, Chez Nymburk, it's been about a slow return to form and justifying their favourites tag, not just in Group F, but in the competition proper. For Hibernia, it's about learning how high the bar is and a bit to rate it themselves in years to come. Matt Hall joins me on co-commentary for this evening's Group F encounter. Matt, as Hibernia make their entrance shortly, we'll take a quick look at Chez Nymburk first. We have to ask the question, just how heavyweight are the Czech heavyweights?
Good evening, Ross. Yeah, I think in Chez Nymburk we've got almost one of the premier European teams. They've played against the best. They play in the same league as Cheska Moscow, so they're playing at this standard every single week, and it's going to be a tough night for Hibernia tonight. They've got an American trio with Michael Dixon at point guard. He's lightning quick from Missouri, looks to penetrate all the time, uses the screen and roll quite a lot, which has been a thorn in the side throughout the competition a little bit for Hibernia. He'll be looking to draw the defenders and get some open shots, but he's also an excellent shooter himself, shooting above 40% from the three-point line. Their main scorer has been Chasen Randall, another American from Stanford. He's averaging just over 16 points a game for Nymburk this season, and he looks to shoot on sight. Got a lovely pull-up jump shot off the dribble, and he'll be a tough matchup for whoever guards him tonight for Hibernia. The final member of the American trio is Julian Vaughan. Nothing too subtle about the way Julian plays. He'll be looking to get inside and dunk everything. You look at his stats this year in this competition, he's shooting 86% from the floor, mainly because everything's been a dunk. He's 13 from 15. Not too highly skilled in the post, but certainly if he gets in the open floor running rim to rim and offensive rebounds, he's going to be really tough. One of the main Czech players is Yuri Welsh, played in the NBA with Boston Celtics in the 90s, 2000 area. So he's seen better days, but he's still at this level. He's an exceptional basketball player. He'll look to play the 1, 2, or 3 position. He's the captain of the team, really the floor leader, and just does everything so smoothly. You can see his talent when you watch how smoothly he goes around the court.
Looking then to Hibernia basketball, the home side in their sixth ever game in European competition. A couple of updates for you news-wise for the squad for this evening. No Sean Van Zandt of Belfast Star, no Keelan Cairns of Belfast Star either. For CNS UCC Demons, you won't see Roy Downey on court this evening, and that's due to the left-hand injury that he picked up last week. It was in fact a hairline fracture that will see him out for the next 10 days and missing club action for County, for his team, I should say. Although there are some positive signs for Hibernia, it is a heavily strapped left arm on player coach Colin O'Reilly, but he is suited up for today, and it does give Hibernia a chance of their best player being out on the floor very much when he's needed. That left arm, again in the heat of Hibernia action, he took a tumble quite heavily into the stand, in fact, last week against Typhoon. But he did manage to score 29 points against GCD Swords Thunder in the Hulu's Men's National Cup on Sunday. So it can't be all that bad. Matt, what can Hibernia hope for in this game?
Well, the injuries are massive towards them, especially with Van Sant and Downey, two of their guards. It leaves Carl Horsford as their main guard that's been playing so far in the competition. So he's going to really have a lot of pressure on him today. And we talked about Dixon and Randall earlier. They're two guards that really like to pick up full court, so he's going to get no break. He's going to rely on a little bit of help, maybe from Paddy Lyons, maybe a little bit from Adrian O'Sullivan. Also, Lamont Colbert has been the centre point inside, so Hibernia really need to try and get him into the game early to establish their inside game, because defensively-wise, Nymburk are really long, really athletic, will make it difficult on the perimeter, so it's important to get inside to Colbert early. That's where the loss of Kearns is really going to affect them a little bit. He's going to get not much of a break. Connor Grace, who's really been the rock of this team throughout the competition, always excellent on offense and defense. It's really going to put a lot of pressure on those two. So it means that the two of those are really going to have no break all game, and they're really going to have to play at their absolute best just to keep themselves in this game, which is always going to be a tough ask anyway against such a quality team.
No sign of sympathy for Hibernia from Chez Nymburk, the strongest possible five they could name. with Peter Benda, Wojciech Ruban, Yuri Velch, Horder Viljansson, and Martin Krysh on the floor for the Czech champions. They've won the domestic double in the Czech Republic for the last 7 years running. A true European pedigree side. And it does look like Colin O'Reilly will be amongst the starting five for Hibernia basketball, and that is a massive boost in a game where every positive will count. Starting five for Hibernia: Connor Grace, Limon Colbert, Colin O'Reilly, Kevin Lacey, and Kyle Hosford. There may be issues with depth later in the game, but for now, that is not a bad Irish five to have out on the floor.
Yeah, excellently calling out there. This morning he wasn't so sure if he was going to play, but we really need him to have one of his better games tonight.
Vaughan v. Colbert, and it's Vaughan with the easy tap down for the former NBA point guard, Yuri Velch. Martin Krysh inside. And the two combine again. And Krysh is off the mark for Chez Nimberk. Colbert that time almost coughing the turnover up to the man who just put the ball in the basket, Martin Krysh. Here's Kyle Hosford to Lacey. Connor Grace, an ever-present for Hibernia, as is Limon Colbert. Tries to get around Vaughan, tucks inside instead. The ball didn't drop, but the two shots will do just nicely.
A good entry pass from Grace there, and with every game that's gone on lately, Colbert's got better and better inside, and I think the more we can find him inside, the better the team's going to do. So a good start there from Hibernia.
And Limon Colbert giving up 8 centimetres on his compatriot, Julian Vaughan, in total. Hibernia giving up 2 centimetres a player throughout the squad. Sound like much, but it amounts to an awful lot in a game of small margins. Wojciech Ruban plays Velch, and it's back with Ruban. That one's long, but Krysh claims the rebound and can't tuck that one home. So what can Velch do from outside? It's cleaned up for Hibernia with Vaughan lurking, looking for the jam. Here's Colin O'Reilly. Finds Hosford, speaking to the players beforehand. They said, if you're trying to think out there, it's already too late. That's the kind of step up and standard for these players. But Grace has been there before. Ruban, and turned over by the Czechs, and it's O'Reilly now on the ball, giving Hibernia a chance. Sucks in the play, goes for three for Lacey. And it's back with the second place team in Group F.
Good pace from Hibernia early on, they're looking to push the ball. But as always, they'll be looking to get a couple of scores for a little bit of confidence.
Inside, Peter Benda started in Eurobasket at the centre position for a team that went all the way to 7th. Best ever finish for the Czech Republic. Here comes Limon Colbert. Turns and gets the shot away, this time over Wojciech Ruban. The score remains 2-0. Bounce pass inside, and it's Peter Benda, doubles the lead for Chez Nimberk. Grace now with Benda for company, but does make it as far as Kevin Lacey. Lacey, who limped out of the last game. And it's unorthodoxly kept in by Nimberk. Velch will settle things down. Might go all the way himself, and it opened all the way up for the former NBA point guard. It doesn't get him much easier than that. Here's Connor Grace. Steps inside Benda to put up the three-pointer and makes it. Good response from Hibernia. They needed that one.
Nicely point shot from Grace, we need a bit of that. He didn't have his best shooting night last week, but good start for him right there as he picked up a foul there on Kevin Lacey.
Grace is at just 26% from the free throw line. But knew where the perimeter was there and stepped out to make the three. Kevin Lacey picks up the foul. As Welch uses Vaughn to make it inside. Decoy pass for Krejci. Slick move from the Czech Republic side.
Twice in the same play there, we saw the pick and roll and it really creates some issues that we've seen here in the competition for Hibernia as O'Reilly with an open three.
With a head drop for O'Reilly, it's a bit early in the game for that. But the tempo that we would have seen from Chez Nymburk in the return fixture in the Czech Republic a couple of weeks ago, we're not seeing it just yet. And it is allowing Hibernia to stay in the game and maybe even grow into it. But let's see how Welch, Huban and Hauschka, who's just come into the game, combine. Here's Benda on Lacey. Threw up the floater and makes the two for the Czechs. Good pass from Kyle Hosford. It needs that kind of zip on it if they're to maintain possession as O'Reilly and Colbert combine. It's allowed Grace into the paint to hit the two. It might be double scores, but Hibernia will take that one.
Great start from Grace. Made his first two jump shots. He needed that. We're looking for a big game from him today.
Fruman threads the needle and finds the way to the basket. Seven-point lead midway through the first. It could be worse. As Welch eyed up the intercept there. Stepped into the passing lane.
Good move from Grace inside. He's done that often in the competition. If he can get into the paint, he's very good one-on-one, and he's one of the guys at his height that can match up with the longer players than Chez Nymburk.
Colbert spins out of trouble. It's with O'Reilly. We want to make up for that earlier three-point miss. Spins again, tries to find the way around Hauschka, but can't do it without taking steps.
Unlucky by O'Reilly there, just his pivot foot just slipped, but I like to see that aggression. We need that from Colin tonight. They're not going to give us any easy, he's not going to get any open looks. And I see Adrian O'Sullivan has checked into the game today. His enthusiasm and usefulness will do well tonight, hopefully, and he can get some confidence early and let some shots go.
Chez Nymburk, scorer-in-chief, Jason Randall is in the game, but it's Adrian O'Sullivan who's on the ball, and will he go all the way to the basket? It's unorthodox, but it's good from the young Corkman. Puts two in on Bender.
And that's exactly it. That's what we talk about. The same as from Roy Downey. He has no inhibitions. He'll go out there and play hard. If it works, it does. If it doesn't, he won't worry about it. He'll just keep on playing. An excellent move there, going all the way to the basket with a great finish.
Adrian O'Sullivan has played in four games, averaging 12 minutes for Hibernia. Great to see him in action early in this game with a superbly positive contribution on Peter Bender. At the other end is Chasen Randall. Now it's with the other American, Dixon. There's two on the floor, but it's a check that increases the lead. Krejci for two. Grace now with 7 points between the sides. Hosford pulls out of the 3 points. Trying to make something happen here is Connor Grace, but can't do anything with Randall in his face and Dixon on the ball, and here comes Randall. And instantaneously, the introduction of the two Americans has injected some tempo into this FIBA Europe Cup tie.
Not a bad start from Hibernia. You'll see the two different ways the teams play defense against the pick and roll, especially Hibernia having trouble here trying to play man-to-man, but they've switched the last couple of times, whereas Nymburk, with their length, they've tended to switch most screens, which has meant not too many open looks for Hibernia, but Connor Grace has found a couple of the last couple of times down, and hopefully they can continue to create open looks and put the ball in the basket.
Martin Paterka comes in for Peter Benda. It's pretty much a like-for-like swap. Paterka, the taller of the duo. Hosford was short on options. made life kind of difficult for Conor Grace, but it's O'Reilly for the open three. This one's short. O'Reilly won't be happy with his perimeter shooting to date. Chasen Randall knows how to put him in, as does Dixon. And it's carefully orchestrated and well sunk by Ches Nimberg. That's Chasen Randall with a three-pointer, forcing the timeout for Hibernia Basketball.
Great pass outside there, finding the open man. And Nimberg have five players that shoot above 40% from the three-point line, with a couple shooting nearly 50%. So leaving them open on the three-point line is not really an option for Hibernia. But that first time out, the first 6 minutes has flown by. I don't think Colin will be too disappointed there as he talks to his troops, the way they've played. Nimberg are a quality outfit, and they've shown that. It's a case of finding a way to score and finding how to get good options all the time. Colin's missed his first couple of jump shots, but I'm sure he'll find the range if he keeps on being aggressive. But defensively wise, they have to find a way to stop Nimberg. Giving up 19 points in the first 6 minutes of the game is going to make for a tough night if they continue to ship points at that rate.
And it's the guide hand for Colin O'Reilly that shipped the injury last week. You know, we see from the Men's Premier League the players are used to playing week in, week out with some kind of niggle that's not quite right for them. But is it doing enough to put off Colin O'Reilly? Well, we'll have to wait and see.
Yes. On the break here, you see O'Sullivan gets the ball, and as we talk about youthfulness, he just goes straight at Bender, who's way taller than him, goes straight up and over him, gets the contact, unlucky not to get the foul, but superb finish there.
Kieran O'Sullivan is eager and in the game. There's three demons on the floor. One of them is Limon Colbert, who again tries to get turned. Delicate hands, no joy.
We see the quick switch in defense again from Nimberg there. I mean, no one ever gets open, and it's a case of trying to get Colbert inside against one of the smaller guys.
As Dixon goes up for two, well, he was on the radar with the Memphis Grizzlies in 2013. We're starting to see why. O'Sullivan. Grace looks for movement, gets it from Hosford. Starts to open up. The Americans close the gap, so it's back with Adrian O'Sullivan. Thought about the pass to his brother, instead went hard, beat the shot clock. In the corner is Martin Peterka, but it's Dixon again. Hauschka gets a hand to it and allows Randall for another three-pointer. And now the Czechs are in control.
Yeah, offensive rebounds caused costly that time. You can't afford to give them second opportunities. They really, although they're suffering with a height disadvantage, they've really got to try and box out on their boards to help them get the rebounds.
Face guarding. Peterka on Grace. And all Hosford can do is have his team outnumbered. And Dixon kept it simple and hit the two. Here's Hosford now, fast break, but it's turned over with 3-on-1. Hosford recovers. Kieran O'Sullivan with some time on the ball. Grace couldn't step inside Peterka there, has to go back to O'Sullivan. There's 6 seconds on the shot clock, and it's opened up for Kieran O'Sullivan if he can get inside. And that one started in and finished out, and it's a fast turnover. But too fast for Creech, allowing the brothers to combine. And Adrian O'Sullivan was mid-air bear hugged there by Pavel Hauschka, the Czech Nimberg number 10.
It's what we've seen in the previous weeks, that the pace of the game and the relentlessness starting to affect Hibernia a little bit and cause the turnovers. You see the last couple of offenses, they've found the ball difficult to move. Notable that Nimberg have stepped up their defense a little bit, and Hibernia stand around watching a little bit, but that's sure pure tempo.
Nimberg through the quarter century. What can Grace do in the paint? Just about keeps it alive. This time Luke Thompson, a substitute in the game, back to O'Sullivan. And there's a minute to go in this game and in this quarter. Randall is relentless from the three-point line. And the percentages continue to slip for Hibernia. As Dixon lofts one in to Willemsen. It's back with Dixon. Drives hard inside and it opens it up for Peterka, who sinks that one as Nymburk pull further clear. Ronan O'Sullivan, another opportunity for the younger players to get into this game and get experience whilst the heat is still upon them. Adrian O'Sullivan to Grace for three. And Chez Nymburk have done nothing spectacular, but it just so happens they've put up a 30-point quarter and lead by 24, Matt.
Yeah, just the shooting percentages from Chez Nymburk. You know, yes, we've given up a few rebounds, but they're shooting above 60% from both the three-point line and from the two-point line. Yeah, well, in fact, they're 100% from the three-point line at the moment. So it's very difficult to guard against. Hibernia haven't played their very best, but in fairness, they've had very few open shots, and those that they've had haven't quite gone in for them. I mean, they're going to need to make everything in order to stay in this game, but even then, it's going to be a tough choice. But, you know, the 7 points that they've scored isn't reflective of how good they've been in other games this tournament, so I know Connor will be disappointed with that now. They really need to come out in the second quarter and really go for everything, pick up the pace of the game, try and match Nymburk for pace, which we saw in that, especially in the second half of that first quarter, and try and create a few open baskets.
Well, throughout this campaign, Hibernia can't be faulted for effort, but sometimes there's been opportunities that have presented themselves that just haven't gone in, Matt.
Yeah, those are the kind of shots, you know, Kieran's an excellent three-point shooter. Connor Grace had a couple, you know, there we see Connor pulling up for a three. We kind of need all of those to go in on this night in order to be in the game, and because of the pressure that Nymburk have created on Hibernia, that puts even more pressure when you do get open shots and puts a bit more pressure on people's shoulders, and those shots that they normally would make, you know, you tend to find a little bit harder.
And Willemsen calls the head play. May not be a household name in Irish basketball, but he's the starting guard for an Icelandic national team that made it all the way to Eurobasket. That doesn't sound like an incredible achievement. Bear in mind, there's more people living in Cork than there is on the island of Iceland. Here's O'Sullivan to Luke Thompson. Started in this game back in November in the Czech Republic. And there was a hand in there from Dixon that took all the sting out of O'Sullivan's three-point efforts. Dixon, however, gets a clean look this time as Thompson gathers. And there's that aggressive basketball from Adrian O'Sullivan as he goes low to keep it clean. And it is a long way from home, Limon Colbert. So it's back with Adrian O'Sullivan. The turnovers are down, but the stats are down too.
Again, the defense from Nymburk, so impressive. Barely getting inside the key, which we've seen them be able to do the last couple of weeks. It's really proven difficult for them offensively.
Czechs spread the floor. Creates a chance for Vaughan, but there was a travel along the way. And Luke Thompson just about did enough there.
I have to say, it's really nice to see the three young fellas in, Thompson, O'Sullivan, and Vaughan O'Sullivan into the game. I'm really impressed with the way Adrian's played. I mean, I've seen him have some huge points in junior internationals. I really like to see him go hell for leather in this game and take his shots. You know, the game looks beyond us already, but there's plenty they can learn and gain from experience in this game, and they really have to grasp this opportunity.
And Mate Svoboda is in the game, and he's on Kyle Hosford. Here's Thompson with Dixon for company. It's an open three for Hosford. And the Demons man punished time and space on that occasion. And what will it prompt from the Czechs? The Icelandic point guard takes his time and takes on Ronan O'Sullivan. Fades away and hits the two. That's some classy operating from Willemsen there. O'Sullivan
Excellent job from O'Sullivan there. Went at them in the post there and got called for a foul. So I think it'll be end-line shot. But here we see Ronan not scared to take it into the key. And really, the two big guys, whether it be Colbert, O'Sullivan, or even Connor Grace, they've been really the only ones that can get look to penetrate inside against the bigger players in there. As a turnover by O'Sullivan there.
And O'Sullivan sends the Icelanders to the mat. Big hit there, but held the hands up straight away. And here come the checks. Svoboda, it's open for Vaughan, who feeds Dixon. Back with Svoboda. And all Vaughan wanted to do there was get in under that basket. He had four dunks last time out against the Irish.
Yeah, and Dixon's really picking them apart there off the screen and roll. Again, two screen and rolls in the play, eventually in a foul, but Dixon's just going to take his time. You can see him looking for his partner in crime, Vaughan, all the time as he gets the ball back there, and it'll start with another screen and roll.
Dixon, point guard, finds Peterka for three. Effortless from the check. Press is on from Nymburk. They're going for the jugular. And Peterka makes the two, and we'll get a chance to extend it.
Yeah, that's where you see the trouble for Hibernia there, missing two of their guards when the pressure's really put on. It proves very difficult for them to break the press there.
Sullivan thought he got a freebie there, but that in fact is a second infringement. And that means Connor Grace comes back into the game. Grace, the number 14, on a foul himself. And Peterka gets the bonus and pushes Nymburk further clear. And that would have been the most spectacular accidental basket of the evening had it gone in, but it's presented an opportunity for Hosford to open things up.
Yeah, the press being put on, I mean, the closer that Hibernia come to their own end line, the more pressure they're going to be under. They really need to get someone to get themselves open at half court or in the middle of the three-point line in order to break the press. So one of the big guys needs to come back, get the ball, and move off them in order to break the press easy.
And that one is fired inside, but Peterka can't hold on to it. Vaughan can, albeit on his backside. It's with Svoboda, the substitute, out to Dixon. And what can they do in broken play? Well, if it's allowed Kevin Lacey to keep running, and he'll keep going to find Grace. And that gimme was given away by Temple Oaks, usually reliable number four. And it's allowed Nymburk to come back down the other end.
Yeah, and that's what you get from the pressure that Nymburk have put on defensively, unfortunately. It really tires you out, lose your concentration a little bit, and something that Connor would normally finish in his sleep ends up in a miss. Yeah, good pressure on the floor there, diving the ball. Ends up in a missed shot eventually from Dixon down the lane, I think, and starts the fast break.
Willemsen. Grace gets in the way. And coming into the game for Chez Nymburk is Theodore Dlugosz, 5'11" point guard, but it's Svoboda off the right hand side. Easy three. Now comes Grace with a point to prove. Maciej Svoboda coughs up the foul there. Dylan Cunningham, his first contribution to the game is to feed Adrian O'Sullivan. Cunningham, who's played in played in two of the away games. This is his first appearance on home court for Hibernia.
You see, there's no switch, there's no let up in the pressure switching defense here from Limburg, so there's going to be nothing given to Hibernia. They're going to have to earn everything they get in this game. But the fouls are starting to mount up a little bit here, and that'll put them into penalty the next time, so Hibernia need to keep being aggressive here against this press.
Cunningham, the Galway man, feeds Adrian O'Sullivan of Cork, and it's opened up in the lane, but it's rejected by Julian Vaughan. So it's back with Svoboda, and that's good covering from Kevin Lacey. It's opened again for Svoboda. Same opportunity, same result. 3 points for the small forward.
And incredibly, Nymburg a 6 from 9 from the 3-point line, shooting 66%, which even in an empty gym is still good shooting. So you know, you really can't afford to leave them open at all. And it's proven the downfall here of Hibernia.
There was Connor Grace with the effort from the elbow that time. It's with Lugosz under pressure from Kevin Lacey. Eventually feeds Svoboda. Nearly had the hat-trick, but Peterka pushed it in.
Yeah, and tough quarter for Hibernia so far. Nymburg have really put up the pressure. We have seen a little bit of decent basketball, but this pick and roll is really what Nymburg have done excellently well. You see, it's nearly always Rand that starts the pick and roll. It's proven very difficult for Horsford to get round him. Dixon's really been able to pick his passes whenever he's liked. Offensively, for Hibernia in that quarter, they found it difficult to create open looks. We've managed to get one or two, but the shots haven't quite fallen. But Nymburg are giving away nothing inside. They're not allowing that easy penetration into the key, as you see the boys concentrating on what Coach O'Reilly's to say. But 10 points they'll be disappointed with. They are better than that. They can do better than that. And they really need to keep on trying to create good screens, get open looks, and cause the Nymburg defense to break down a little bit.
Nymburg could be playing X's and O's at this point on their strat board, and it'd still be working for them.
So there you see the pick and roll, and once Dixon gets around that pick and roll, it's very difficult for Hibernia to stay with him, and he can make any pass he wants there. If they defend the basket, he kicks it to the open three-point man. If they defend the three-point man, they kick it right inside to Randall, and he ends up with a dunk.
So midway through the second, Hibernia.
So this is one of the better ones from Hibernia here. Horsford comes off a great screen there from Colbert and nails a wide open three, and that's what we need to see more of in order for us to get some more points on the board. They're not going to break them down one-on-one, so you need to create open looks with good screens and good movement.
Lacey's open this time. It's short from the swordsman. Here's Willemsen. Lugosz back to Willemsen. Peterka now. It's good off the ball movement from Svoboda, and here he is. Went a long way to claim that one, and he'll sling it out, but step out along the way.
The guys have had a little rest in the timeout there. With 5 minutes to go, it's time to really pick up the pace at both ends of the floor. Go flat out. You see the two big guys have gone long here. They can't afford to just get out of the play. They need to be there ready for the pass to break this press.
Cunningham for Lacey. Over. Knows he can't back in, but he might drive hard. Takes on Vaughan this time and does make the two.
And in all the last few games we've seen at home, Limon Cole has been more than a match inside for any of the players he's played against one-on-one. And that's something that Hibernia needs to keep going to in order to get open looks. You see a massive dunk there from Randall inside.
A pinpoint pass and a flourishing finish from the American. First dunk of the game. It may be the first of many, or at least that's what Vaughan would like to have happen. And Hibernia can't replicate it down the other end.
Yeah, great move inside, takes the extra dribble just to avoid the long arms of Colbert and ends up with a big slam.
O'Sullivan from the elbow. Here comes Svoboda. Dlugosz pulls up. The gap is astonishing at this point, but it won't deter the Irish. Cunningham, O'Sullivan, Grace for three off the left hand. But he is a Kittoke. Vaughan is far out from the basket as we've seen him in this game, but it's created an opportunity. Fast break is on if Kevin Lacey can hit the gas. And Dylan Cunningham went right, Lacey went left and missed with the jump shot.
Good choice from Lacey to go inside there, but couldn't quite get the finish.
Had to step back to get open, but it was an open three. And a fine finish from Maciej Svoboda. Nymburk through the half century. And the turnover rate is down in this game, and it has on at least the last two games, Matt. They may not be creating opportunities, but they're turning the ball over less.
Yes, certainly are turning the ball over less. Like, Nymburk play a slightly different type of defense. They're switching a lot. They're relying on their length. What it means is they're not trying to get their hands on the ball so much, but you'll see the lack of penetration, which we've seen a lot of penetration from Hibernia in the last couple of games, but with turnovers. This time we're seeing no penetration, but zero turnovers, because Nymburk are simply not allowing them to get past them. But they're also just relying on waiting until Hibernia eventually miss a shot or take a bad shot, the shot clock runs out, in order to get their stops and get out the other way.
They are quite a miserly team anyway in this FIBA Europe Cup. As O'Sullivan makes the free throw.
Hey, Adrian had an extra little patch there. You can see, you know, he's exhausted. He's played well over 10 minutes in a row there, but really worth his spot on there, and really good to see him putting in some good minutes and showing everyone what he can do in this game.
Nymburk's captain is back on the floor. It's Welsh, who hits Michael Dixon, who once again hits the three.
And again, out of the screen and roll, they end up with an easy look as they put the pressure on, but great pass from O'Sullivan.
And that one just came up off the court to Dylan Cunningham.
Great use of the screen and roll there, and again they take the inside pass, but they leave the three-point shot wide open. And on the other end, well, our screen and rolls, they're switching a lot, and Hibernia trying to dribble around the man switching out, whereas they need to really try and pass the ball inside or split the gap a little bit in order to stop Nymburk from jumping out on them on the screen and rolls. There we see Svoboda with a three-point shot. He's 3 from 4 from the three-point line. So at some point, they're going to have to get out and get a hand up in the lane on the shot for him, because he doesn't look like he's going to miss too many tonight.
Well, it's a special kind of sweat that's been spilled onto the Tala floor this evening as we hold up play to make sure there's a safe playing surface for the basketballers. Connor Grace, quick handoff to Dylan Cunningham. Opportunity here. And it's the men in black as Welsh with a simple pass to Svoboda, who is shooting at a phenomenal percentage this evening in Tala.
Yeah, often be said it's a difficult place to shoot in this arena, but you wouldn't know from Svoboda and the way that Nymburk is shooting tonight from the 3-point line. Unbelievable shooting.
Svoboda shooting at 80% now. How about Hosford with the fadeaway? In and out from the point guard. As Paterka goes in the charge. Beautiful hands from Dixon back to his big man inside. And a superb two-pointer as Nymburk hit 60. Grace now puts Cunningham on the run. It's with Hosford. Will need to beat Dixon if he's to create something himself, but he finds Colbert, who will take on the big man and draws the foul. And that's where we've seen a little bit of success for Colbert.
Yeah, great spin move from Colbert. Gets under the arm, definite foul there. And again, Nymburk don't make it easy to pass the ball inside. It's, you know, I think we can all see that when we have got it inside, we've done quite well, and especially Colbert has been able to create stuff. But Nymburk do an excellent job of not allowing Colbert or O'Sullivan or Grace to get a position inside in order to pass the ball into them. You know, so it's not as easy as just getting the ball inside, although that definitely is where we need to go.
Levon Colbert makes his first free throw of the game. It's opened up, and Colbert repays the favour by sending the big man to the line at the other end.
Another great move from Dixon here. He just creates a little bit of space, and no choice but to foul with Colbert there, otherwise we'd seen another dunk from Vaughan.
Unorthodox style there from Vaughan. He doesn't bend the knee the way you'd expect from basketballers.
No, he doesn't bend the knee, but that'll probably be why he's shooting 38% from the free throw line from the season. As he managed to make two from two, he's 50% in this competition and only 33% in the league. And you can see from the unusual style, that's probably why.
Sullivan for Colbert. Peterka. It's back with Dixon. He hasn't made a mistake all day. He takes on Hosford. I don't think anyone knew whether that was a shot or an alley-oop, but nevertheless, it's back with Mike Collins. Dylan Cunningham, who loses control of that one at a vital moment, as Hosford does enough to stop Dixon, but not legally so.
Yeah, he was the last man, Hosford. Lucky not to get away with the intentional foul there, stopping the play on the fast break, but good foul. Although it will result in two shots, though, and Dixon shoots above 80% from the free throw line, so I'm sure he'll be confident of getting two anyway.
There's an overlap here, and it's allowed Vaughan to do what he does best. The American with the big dunk. Looks like Colbert's got some game too, though. He didn't slam it in, but it's 2 points nonetheless for Hibernia. And a good response there as we count down to the end of this second quarter. And the former Boston Celtics man sets up the play and takes it on. But it's into the corner. And that is Dixon once again. And a classy finish from the Czechs. 69 points in 20 minutes of basketball. Colbert sniping in there, a rare opportunity for Hibernia, Matt.
Yeah, really tough half of basketball for Hibernia. I mean, they've, throughout five games, they've put in everything they've got. They've continued to get better throughout, but I think the disappointment of last week, when they really felt they had a chance to compete in the game and win the game, is showing here, along with a few injuries. And disappointing first half. I mean, I think the three-point shooting from Nymburk has been unbelievable at 10 from 15, 66%. You don't see that in a gym with nobody else in, but in fairness to them, they've created easy looks and taken the pressure off by their defense up the other end, really made it difficult in order for Hibernia to create anything.
Matt, the fans that have come here have come as much to see the Czechs in action as they have to see the Irish do their best.
Yeah, you have to say they've been hugely impressive so far, that the Nymburk team passed the ball really well. The pick and roll with Randall has been pretty much unstoppable. They've had anything they've wanted once they put the ball off. Dixon has been hugely impressive the way he's run the floor, created for the pick and roll, picking out the easy pass here. And you see Dixon again with another pass there. He's the top assist man on their team, and just consistently always makes the right choice, whether it be out of the three-point line or inside to his partner in crime, Randall. But that's made it really difficult for Hibernia to defend. And not only that, is Dixon stepped out along with Randall and made some three-point shots as well to make it extremely difficult.
Dixon with six assists in that half, matched only by the captain, Yuri Velch, for Ches Nimberk. And assists have been something that Hibernia have found hard to come by. They are down the bottom of the rankings in the assists front. It's been Hosford who has led the way with 2.5 assists per game. But just Grace Thompson and Adrian O'Sullivan credited with the dishes thus far.
Yeah, a lot of assists really show the quality of a team, and Nimberg share the ball really well, make it very difficult for Hibernia to stay with them. From halftime, Cornell will take them in there now, and he'll really be trying to G them up. It's been an excellent competition, a good learning curve for the team, and he'll really be asking them to give one final effort of this half and show the fans here that have turned up in Tallaght and the ones that watch from home what they are capable of, because you know, you can see a little bit of nerves, and that comes from the tempo that's been on the game and the lack of opportunity they've been given Nimberg. But they really have to try to put that half behind them and come out in the second half and put in a performance that shows a little bit more of what they are capable of.
We have no doubt that the exhibition will continue in the FIBA Europe Cup. We're 12 minutes away from the second half. Join us shortly. And as we join the second half, and already Nymburker trying to do things fancy-like. Here's Kevin Lacey. And Dixon takes it on. Svoboda.
Nice break from Hibernia there. Great penetration from Adrian O'Sullivan. Finds the wide open Kevin Lacey, but as we've seen, the shots haven't quite gone, and there's a wide open space there for Svoboda to get all the way to the basket, and he'll continue his scoring run from the foul line.
So with the second half underway here in the FIBA Europe Cup, Hibernia with a chance to lick the wounds. Nymburk with an opportunity to look back on what was a startling first half, particularly when you look at the stats, you realize four players off the bench in double digits. Shooting at 66.7% from the free throw line. Dixon was unstoppable and continues in that vein, takes his tally to 15 points.
Yeah, Dixon's having a phenomenal game. He started that break, made a great cross-court pass to find Randall wide open on the opposite wing. It ends up coming back to him, and he hits another three.
Arm out from Kevin Lacey. We'll rule out anything that follows next. Kruban was not for stopping on this occasion, and Lacey did lead with the arm. Hibernia with the inbounds. What can they do? Sullivan puts one up for three. Lacey's fumble opens it up for Nymburk, and it's Svoboda with another punishing two.
Yeah, again, all comes from Dixon. Penetration, picks up his seventh assist of the game there, and it's all too easy for him at the moment. Nice pass inside there, and a great finish from Colbert.
Rolls around, finishes it home. Colbert goes to 7 points. Hosford checks back to present Connor Grace with a chance for three, but it's Dixon now. And his collection of the ball, his acceleration into the half court, and his thought process and what to do next all seemed in one movement there as Chasen Randall lines up a three. He presents a rebound and the dunk for Vaughan. And Colbert could only stand back and watch. Sullivan for Grace, takes the ball out, spins inside, still going Grace, picked up the foul, and there was a 19-0 run in the first half, and Grace stops a run from Nymburk in the second.
Here we see Vaughan just out-muscles Limon Colbert inside, and Colbert being the only big guy for us here, you know, he can't afford to pick up a foul, so just gives up the dunk to Vaughan.
Hibernia to 20 points, something they wish they'd done probably about 15 minutes ago. Second one rims out. Dixon doesn't look to be in a hurry, but is trying to get things going. And a direct pass inside for Vaughan brings it back for Kruban. And they're spacing it well, and it allows Vaughan to go in again. Another jam for the American. He loves it.
Great ball movement from Nymburk here. It's just all too easy for them, but excellent passing and movement there, and they end up with an easy dunk inside again.
O'Sullivan pulls up, hits one from 15 feet. And Adrian just wants to contribute to this game. Randall with a pass to no one, but Adrian O'Sullivan has been playing like a man absolutely with a point to prove. Sure, he's been averaging 12 minutes a game to date, but he's been nothing but positive since he's come into this game.
Yeah, Adrian's having an excellent game, really been aggressive. A great screen last time from Colbert, managed to get him open.
Pass for it on Randall. It's opened up for Limon Colbert. Not just an inside player. When the opportunity presents from 23 feet, Colbert will take it. Jason Randall worked out with a number of NBA teams over the summer. Shows Nimberg. Dixon advances, feeds Ruban. And Ruban feeds the net and Tala.
The great shooting just continues from Nimberg here. Another foul is called.
Sullivan again. They need his enthusiasm. No luck with the finish there. He runs back to try and track down Ruban, who may go all the way. Superb swing out. And is duly met with a three-pointer, another from Dixon. Nimberg still doing the simple stuff well. And we'll see dunks and we'll see big three-point plays. Nimberg's defense has been almost as impressive in this game as they've shut down anything Hibernia have had to offer. It's inside for Ruban, quick hands, loose finish. Hosford goes, pulls back and tries to set something up, but there's two players inside. It's opened up for Kieran O'Sullivan.
Yeah, just checked into the game there. Tough to make those shots, but those are the shots that we need to hit. Some good ball movement. As we see the great ball movement again for Randall with a wide open three.
It's shooting practice now for Nimberg. With the need of the practice in that occasion, two consecutive misses. And there's just a bit of energy missing from Hibernia at the moment. You normally see them canter down court to get into position. It's getting harder and harder. But O'Sullivan will keep going.
Yeah, actually Hibernia showed a little bit more offensively in that quarter. The pick and roll worked a little bit better in that quarter. Managed to move the ball a little bit better. Here you see the first pick and roll. I think this is going to be Kyle Horford comes off the pick and roll there, and because of the great dive, because we actually hit him with a screen, he had the choice inside or outside. He went outside to Colbert, and here you see a great sprint fit screen from Colbert, managed to create a bit of space inside, and Adrian O'Sullivan was one-on-one with a big guy. Those are two things that we've been getting beat with all day long, but that's the first time we've really seen that work for Hibernia and be able to create those one-on-one opportunities and the opportunity for Horford and O'Sullivan to make choices the way that Dixon's been making choices for Nimberg the whole game long.
Hibernia assistant coach Puff Summers taking this time out, albeit with Colin O'Reilly on the shoulder just in case.
Here you see, again, great break. You see the awareness from Nimberg every time they come down, always looking for that open man. As the three Hibernia players go crowd in, it's that man Dixon again, wide open on the three-point line, and he's missed very little today from that range.
Nimberg have averaged 80 points per game in the FIBA Europe Cup. They're at 85 with 14 minutes still to play. Hibernia well short of their average tally of 60. Theodore Glugosz and Willemsen back in the game. Here is Glugosz. Short and with O'Sullivan. Instantly has Willemsen for company. Now it's Glugosz who takes the attention. But Kieran O'Sullivan has found a little bit of space to find Hosford. And Culver tries the inside move on Creech.
Great move from Colbert there. Really attacks him here, gets the bump and feels the bump and puts the shot up, makes a great finish. There you see it. Just reaching forward, hits him with his chest. That'll be a foul all day long and a great finish from Colbert, and he'll get the chance to go to a line for, with a chance to make a three-point play.
Zeman Colbert approves his return from the free throw line. Good press here from Hibernia, and it allows Kieran O'Sullivan to make the steal. Hosford eyes the options, feeds O'Sullivan. It's back for his brother.
Hibernia just sees the opportunity here as Dixon sits down to pick the pace up a little bit, put a bit more pressure on, and have to see how the Nymburk backup guards can handle the pressure here.
Willemsen from the top. And that's top class from the Icelandic point guard. Showing Hibernia how it's done when the open three presents itself. Ronan O'Sullivan is in the game. He's 6'8" of pure intent. And O'Sullivan this time won't be pleased with his return to date. No look pass from Willemsen in the corner. Good rebound from Svoboda, who can't stop scoring. Massive contribution off the bench.
Yeah, it's 18 points for Svoboda, and he's been non-stop scoring this whole time in there. Whenever he's come in, he's looked to score from the 3.9 and inside.
Good pass, and another open three, and this time Kieran O'Sullivan converts.
Great pass from Colbert, and you'll see it eventually. It's difficult to come off the bench and score straight away, but eventually we give O'Sullivan enough looks. The great steal from Hosford there, he's going to make a basket. Unlucky there.
Best of intentions from Kyle Hosford, but made to pay by Martin Creech. One of the smallest on the court is Hosford, but can dunk the ball. As Colbert earns another trip to the free throw line.
You see there, a great choice from Colbert there. On the defense against the pick and roll, they decided to deny this pick and roll and take away the basket, but they leave Colbert open on the three-point line when they choose to play defense that way. Hibernia just need to try and create more of those opportunities. When they've tried to run pick and roll, they haven't held the screens long enough and allowed Nymburk to get around them easily or get through the gap easily. Those just occasions, they just need to be a bit more physical when they set their screens. I mean, they don't have a Randall, a Vaughan inside, but they need to be as physical as they can in order to create these easy opportunities.
Liam Colbert has most certainly earned himself a sus bug at the National Basketball Arena. He's led by example today. Nymburk to a man, or an exhibition of how good basketball is played, as Willemsen pulls up and hits the two from the elbow. And these subs are playing for contracts. There'll be no let up. As Hosford looks to go all the way, it's over the top. Grace can't get a hand on it.
Good drive from Hosford again. That came from a good screen from Connor Grace there. If they can keep that up, you know, they'll create more opportunities. The game has obviously gone for them now, but they just need to keep learning from that and keep pushing the pace and get as many baskets as possible.
And here comes Glugosz. It's kicked out. Back with Willemsen. Good defense from Hibernia here, making it difficult for the Czechs. But the pros know how to do it. Beats the buzzer with a big three.
Yeah, Wilhelms comes to the bench here. It's three in a row there, showing that he's got the hot hand as well, and doesn't seem to matter who they put in. They can't seem to miss the basket from range.
O'Sullivan with the drive. As this third quarter counts down, Luke Thompson misses and tries to cover Peterka. He takes on Willemsen now. But it's opened it up for Svoboda. Peterka with the offensive rebound. It's back for Dlugosz. It's shooting practice for the Czechs. And Dlugosz shows they don't necessarily need it. O'Sullivan this time. O'Sullivan takes his tally to 5 points. A good third quarter for the Corkmen after a difficult start, but it's Nymburk out to the ton. And Hibernia on 34 points.
We see the difficulty of playing in this stand. It takes so long to adjust to this standard. And especially with a few injuries this week, players that haven't perhaps played that much in the last couple of weeks are now being called on to take a lot more shots. But in this quarter, a lot better offensively. We've created more shots and we've managed to hit a few once they kind of got their confidence. Kieran O'Sullivan has come into the game a little bit more there. He's had a couple of open looks. I think this time we'll see it goes into Colbert, which we were asking for, and he makes a great decision back out to O'Sullivan. And after a couple of warm-ups, he makes that three, something we see him do week in, week out. Again, here you see good position in there from Colbert. Makes a good decision as soon as the double team comes out to the open, Sullivan, and he knocks that down really well. You see it from a different angle here, there. It's something that they haven't done too often, is double team. They've managed to, they've normally stayed with their man, but they were made to pay that time from O'Sullivan. But the ball movement and the use of screens has been a lot better in this quarter from Hibernia. Something they need to keep up to in the end of this game, to the rest of this game. They've created more shots because they've set better screens, created more opportunities themselves to break down the Nymburk defense. That's something that they have to learn to do in order to play at this level. This that last basket, I think, from O'Sullivan, and again, this comes from a screen. I think he curls off this screen, a great pass from Horsford, and that's a quality finish there from O'Sullivan. So we see what we can do when we set good screens, make good decisions, but it needs to be non-stop. There can be no let-up on setting up good screens and using good screens. The Nymburk defense, and the same with all these teams at this level, they're not going to give you any easy baskets or any easy looks. You need to create them.
Heading into this fourth quarter, we know that Nymburk will not ease up. There's players off the bench playing for contracts, playing for their livelihoods. There's five players to date who've come off the bench and already in double digits. Svoboda is one of them. Here's Hauschka. Dlugosz again. Nips out but coughs it up to Hosford, who'll advance, pull up, accidental pass to Grace, but it might work out. Deft pass inside from Grace as Sullivan tries to get turned. Unlucky for the Corkman, who calls Galway home these days. Dlugosz at the tiller. Hauschka, it's messy, but Krish has it. Inside to Peterka. Can't get around Ronan O'Sullivan. Better defense from Hibernia, but Krish just kept that ball out of danger until the last possible moment for two. Hosford now looks up and sees five big black uniforms all wanting to make life difficult for him. And in as much math as we won't see a let up from Nymburk, we will see Colin O'Reilly and the Hibernia staff looking to blood these younger players. So much of this entire Hibernia project was based around giving Irish players and emerging talent access to the very highest competitions that they can take part in, and that's what the FIBA Europe Cup is for these young players.
Yeah, it's something, you know, they'll have learned from over the six games, whether they've played or not played. I mean, they're getting a good run in this game, and you see there's a great pass from Sullivan to Colbert inside. You'll see they're starting to learn and play at this level. They know throughout this game, but, you know, they're learning all the time. It's something they need to take with them and remember, you know, for the rest of our season, of the speed and level they need to play at in order to play at this level of competition.
Good contribution from Ronan O'Sullivan there. Lovely pass inside. And Thompson now, another youngster. The Svoboda gets around him. And it's with Dlugosz. There's been nothing fanciful about the Czechs. They've just gone about their job, and that's what it is to these players. As O'Sullivan with a massive pass to his brother Kieran, who spins inside, can't get out of trouble, but will get a trip to the line.
Great vision from Adrian, and again, not afraid to make that decision and get that ball up forward, and a great move there from brother Kieran, and great up and under, picked up the foul, and good free throw shooters. So hopefully he'll hit two from here, but I have to say, been really impressed with the youngsters, especially Adrian O'Sullivan and Ronan O'Sullivan. Ronan's not back down at all defensively. He's been right up, denying that screen and roll. Offensively, you saw one just rim out for him last time down, but again, not afraid to make a move inside, and you really see the emergence of those two, you know, in particular in this game for some of the younger players getting minutes.
And Q, the youngest member of the squad, with a chance to come in and make an impression, as he has done in previous games. He's scored in two of them and will look to make an impression in the fourth. Patrick Lyons from SSE or Tricity Moycullen in the Men's Premier League, but it's Hibernia on a Wednesday, and a dunk for Nymburk's number 22, Maciej Svoboda. Here's Lyons on the ball, and this is good passing from Hibernia, and that just needed the finish from Ronan O'Sullivan to make it onto the highlights reel. It did look the part though. Here's Creech. Peterka, Svoboda now, and Ronan O'Sullivan is putting in a decent shift defensively, happy to take on the bigger players.
Yeah, and offensively bursting down, excellent pass from Sullivan. We've seen the dunk back door there, difficult to stop that once they get the ball into the key, but certainly the energy of the younger players here has really picked up, and they'll keep playing to the end, that's for sure.
The four players on the court in their early 20s, one of them is Lyons, trying to find the senior Limon Colbert, but it's Dlugosh and the alley-oop. And now the Czechs put on a show in Tala. Raises a cheer from the crowd. Hard to be neutral when the basketball is just that good. And that's a misplaced fire in from Adrian. And sets up Hauschka. Look at determination in Lyons' face. And when Colin O'Reilly talks about players knowing what they have to do to make the grade and make the step up, you can see it in these youngsters, like O'Sullivan with the finish. Good drive from the young Corkman.
Great move from Adrian there. Doesn't settle for the three-point shot. Puts the ball on the floor and attacks. Gets always the rim, and a great finish with his left hand.
Hauschka kicks it out, and the three is reined in from Theodore Dlugosh.
Yeah, the last couple of minutes here, they've been in that zone for Nymburk here. They've been in a zone which has allowed a bit more passing, a little more freedom from Hibernia.
So it's an all Czech five on the floor for Nymburk. Their imports have their job done. Hauschka has something left to contribute. Ronan O'Sullivan takes on Peterka. Nearly loses it, but it's back with Colbert. Nice pass. The fake from O'Sullivan. Couldn't convert the pass, and it's 2-on-1 for Nymburk. And all too easy for Svoboda.
Yeah, timeout from Colin O'Reilly there. Just want to stop the rot. Doesn't want it to end as it gets away from us. Here you'll see a great fast break, and Dlugosh with a great pass. And that's that man, Svoboda, again, with a great dunk finish on the fast break. Just the vision and control, 2-on-1, and the opportunity to be able to throw it up. Such an athletic play on the end of the play there. Nymburk, for the whole time, defensively, they switched into a zone, maybe giving Hibernia a little bit more space to breathe, but the end result hasn't really changed here, as they've cleaned up on the defensive boards and continue to be a great shooting team from outside, as well as a couple of dunks here. O'Reilly will just be telling his troops here, 4 minutes, 36 seconds left in this experience. Make sure you give it everything you can, learn as much as you can, and play as hard as you can right till the end. And, you know, they've done that for the whole tournament up to date, and they won't want any let up now in this last 4 minutes, 36 seconds.
And a real Galway flair to Hibernia down the fourth with three Moycullen based players and two demons on the floor. Here's Lyons. Dylan Cunningham puts back inside, and Ronan O'Sullivan's got a chance.
Great move from O'Sullivan there, really deserved better. Got his man up, went to his left hand, and Ronan's got the skills to bottom him inside if he gets a good look.
Hauschke now, who's the only Nymburk player not to score in this game so far. Creech is on the board, so too is Svoboda. And play will continue. And Cunningham thought about the three, elected instead to go to the big man. Here's O'Sullivan again. That spin has yielded opportunities for him, and it's opened it up as the smallest man on the floor went for one of the hardest shots to execute. No dunk for Lyons, but a trip to the charity stripe nonetheless.
You have to love to see this. This is what Ronan's great at. Makes a great spin move, realizes he's not there, creates a great decision, get his man up. You have to love Paddy going all the way up for the dunk, getting fouled on the basket too, but that's what you get from the younger players. No fear.
As they say out west, not a bother on you. And that's a third EB Euro Cup scoring performance for Patrick Lyons. Lugosh calls the head play, and it's opened it up for the big dunker.
Yeah, Hibernia in the zone there, and just Ronan O'Sullivan just caught off his spot there, as he makes another great pass there to Dylan.
Super pass. The Moycullen boys combining well, and Dylan Cunningham gets his first 2 points of the FIBA Europe Cup.
Yeah, really can't say enough about how impressed they've been with the way Ronan's played today. Just, the zone has suited him, but really he's making good passes and good options. Has really been some of the best basketball we've seen from Hibernia, especially in this game.
As Hosford pulls up for three. But both teams have as much reason, for different reasons, to play in this fourth quarter. Hibernia looking to just gloss the finish on what's been a grueling 6 weeks for the amateurs. Whereas for full-timers, it's their job to keep pushing hard.
Yeah, here's another great basket. Ball goes inside of Ronan, and a great backdoor cut from Cunningham, and he ends up with a great finish there. But great assist from Ronan to his Moycullen teammate.
All the way across for Dlugosh, but it's short. And Hibernia will let that one go out of play. Last touch, a black uniform. And Nymburk settle into that zone defense. What will it present for Patrick Lyons? As it opens up, it goes up high and finishes right where he wanted it. Patrick Lyons takes his tally to three.
Great screen from Kieran O'Sullivan. The foul's called in and one play, but great drive and pull up from Paddy Lyons. You'll see, as much as Ronan has been a great offensive force with his passing and vision, you see why that he's still going to struggle at this kind of standard. His size and height inside is still not quite there to be playing the four and five. And you know, that's why for most of the competition, O'Reilly's had to rely on the stalwarts of Colbert and Grace and the missing Cairns of today.
Playing in one of those positions where you do tend to be that little bit later into your career when you hit your prime. And here comes Adrian O'Sullivan at speed, two hands, and that's a dominating block from Vaughan. But look who pops up in there to turn it over as Dylan Cunningham looked to go all the way. Hands in there, and Dylan Cunningham had a chance to extend his tally.
Good drive from Cunningham. Realised he was taking away the pass and then goes straight at him and just got an arm on the forearm there, and he'll go to line for two. But great to see that Hibernia guys haven't given up the ghost in this game and will play right to the end as expected. Great hustle from Cunningham, doesn't give up on that for the missed free throw. Chase the ball down, and it'll be Hibernia ball from the end line.
So with a minute 20 to go, Hibernia in possession, playing right to the final buzzer. And it's O'Sullivan outside for Adrian O'Sullivan. Average age of the Irish players on the floor in the low 20s.
Again, against one of the top American players, Sean Sullivan here, when he eventually gets hold of it. Not afraid to go at him. Great spin move as he gets the foul. And you have to say, very impressive fourth quarter here from young Ronan O'Sullivan.
Sullivan successful with his second. That's 45 points for Hibernia. Lugosz picks his spot. Two number players go to the deck and it's opened up for Hibernia. And it's Lyons who tries to find the opportunity. O'Sullivan checks his feet. Vaughan was up off the deck in time to claim the offensive rebound. And here he comes. And he's licking his lips at the prospect of getting inside. But it's Creech off the left hand with a simple finish. And as we count down, it's so encouraging to see so many young players on the floor getting the experience that was very much the intention with this unique project in European basketball, a combined sub club side with a special derogation from FIBA Europe just to take part. But for Nymburk, a chance to finish it out with a ball in hand. And a comprehensive tally for Nymburk, 121 points. Hibernia with just 45 to show for themselves. But as Colin O'Reilly will tell you, it's not all about results for Hibernia in the FIBA Europe Cup.
No, I think we saw, you know, a quality side in Nymburk here today. 45 points in the game, and they scored 45 away from home as well against Nymburk. And the defense is all important. Yeah, we're really impressed with the way they shot the ball, which resulted in their high score, 121 points, their dunks inside. But their defense for the whole game was just relentless, not allowing Hibernia to get any of the penetration and the looks they've had in previous games. What you have to say is, although disappointing today, the last two home games and even for parts of the away games have shown in patches, with the patches getting longer and longer, that, you know, with more practice, with more experience, we certainly have the players that can compete at this level. You know, for a group of amateurs that don't get to practice with the team day in, day out, they don't get all the perks that these professionals get. They've certainly matched Back and Bears for a long period of that game. And last week, you know, we saw they were the better team for periods of that game. It's just being able to put together that kind of performance for 40 minutes. But hugely encouraging performance, and great to see an Irish basketball team back in this level of competition.
Nymburk came and did exactly what they were expected to do. They did nothing less but dominate, and that's what we were expecting.
Yeah, from start to finish, just their pace the ball movement, their experience, they play together all the time, but you know, just knowing what each other does, moving the ball around, and here you see finding the open man inside eventually as he cuts the basket. I think it's Krish that gets the basket with a nice left-hand finish, as he did. I think he started with the first 2 points of the game and he finished with the last 2 points of the game.
So the result was not beyond the expectations of anyone who came, but they came nonetheless to see the Irish do their best and the Czechs be the best. Press conference featuring both sides to come shortly, but for now we'll leave you on a final score in the final group game here in the FIBA Europe Cup, and my thanks to Matt. It's finished. Hibernia 45, Chesnimburg 121.
Yeah, I don't forget about the young side part of it. I don't think, regardless of what age players we put out on the floor, we were going to be able to compete with them tonight on the scoreboard. But the positive side of it is we competed them with the intensity, hustle plays, the energy plays. And like I said, the age profile of the group tonight was younger than even the last 5 weeks, which is another good step, because it's good to have these fellas exposed to this high level basketball at a very early age. You know, you need this. You can't learn the trade and by watching game tape of opposition teams. You have to learn it on the fly, on the court, and go up against these full-time pros to understand how hard it is to play at this level. You know, for these guys, I hope they've enjoyed the experience. It's something I would have loved when I was 21, and it's something that they can take back to their own individual careers and build on through strength and conditioning, through extra workouts, and with their club teams, you know. And so hopefully everyone's learned something from this experience. We're not going to look at the results too in-depthly. We're going to look more at the performances and analyse them and give feedback to the players as far as where we feel as a nation, basketball-wise, we stand and where we feel we need to go to improve.
Yeah, absolutely. I suppose there's probably three, maybe four people part of the team that have played at this level before, you know, but for me and maybe, I don't know, six or seven other guys that have never played at this level before. We've never had the professionalism both on and off the court. We've learned an awful lot. It's been absolutely fantastic. People can't take away the experience that I've had in the last 6 weeks, and I've learned a lot both on and off the court. So yeah, it's been successful from that part, and you know, it's a step forward in my own career and a lot of lads' careers, and it's been very, very positive from that point of view.
Change our ambition. We have ambition to continue and make good results. I want to say about the Danish team that they didn't surprise me. They play good basketball and they deserve to be in the first place. I think they will make better results in the future. But for us, you know, we're struggling with a lot of injuries. In the end, we advance. It's good for us. And we expect to make good results, even better next round. Great.
Everything's working fine, working out fine.
I think we will come here again. It's nice. Thank you.